Hello, this is Justin B. Smith, senior correspondent with GBMnews.com. And a little while ago, I interviewed director Raheem Abdur-Briggs of the White Attire Fair and the newfound company Al Sura. Now, Al Sura is actually a new company that will be taking over the White Attire Fair from now on, taking it out of the hands of the Human Foundation. And now we will actually go into that interview at this moment. Hope you enjoy. Catch you later.
So how did you come up with the name Asura, and what does it mean?
Well, the name Al Sura comes from the Quran. It's inspired from the Quran, and it means new chapter and new beginning. It pretty much picks up and reconnects me to the journey and this fight against HIV and AIDS. Whereas the first journey was for my twin brother. This journey basically is for a dear friend that I lost who was a volunteer during my first journey. His name is Patrick Cahosey. So this journey is now for him. Hence Al Sura, meaning a new beginning and a new hope.
So, with that in mind, what is Al Sura's mission?
Well, Al Sura's mission is to raise awareness. His mission is to renew, reconnect, and recommit our awareness in the fight against HIV and AIDS. Our mission is to have social marketing events. During my, like my, unlike my first journey as well, to distribute that money to ASO or AIDS service organizations throughout the Washington, D.C. area. That's primarily what our mission is.
Where did you come up with the logo?
Well, the logo went through a vetting process. I've worked very closely with Ron Thomas and Michael Christopher. I wanted a logo that was very cool, very engaging, while at the same time kind of gave you that wow factor. You know, when you do branding, you want people to look at the organization and look at a logo and say, wow. And you want to engage them, and then you hit them hard with the message of HIV and AIDS awareness in our community.
Oh,
So
wow.
I kind
Okay.
of wanted to come up with a logo that was kind of cool. At the same time, that had a tagline where it says renew, reconnect, and recommit our awareness.
Oh, wow. That's a very powerful statement.
Is Asura the company that will hold the White Attire every year as Yuma did?
Absolutely. Al Sura will actually pick up where Yuma has left off. Al Sura will be the owner of the White Attire Fair, which will be housed under Al Sura. And I'm going to let the cat out of the bag. The event is now owned and copyrighted by Al Sura. I think this is going to excite a lot of folks because they want to ensure that as the founder of the White Attire Fair that I had complete autonomy and control of the event, its branding, and its venture offerings.
What exactly is the White Attire Fair?
Well, the White Attire Fair is an annual event that we have each year. It's a social marketing program or social marketing venture that we have annually and is held in Washington, D.C. Now, this event draws thousands of people around the country within the African American community and is the number one HIV/AIDS social marketing event in the country. So it's huge. It draws thousands of people, and everyone always wants to know what's going to happen next, where we're going to have it. And the good thing about the White Attire Fair is that it has its own cachet. It has its own level of excitement, and folks really look forward to it. So we're glad that we'll be back in 2009.
When is it expected to take place? Like next year, in 2009, like what month?
Well, usually July is the month that we have the White Attire Fair. It will be July, Saturday, July 18th, 2009. And we have it marked on our calendar. We're pulling together a team. A call to service will be held in September 26th to have folks who are interested in joining our efforts and taking a trip on this second journey of mine, hence Al Sura, which will be housing the White Attire Fair. So we're really excited about it. I'm very excited about it, and my team's excited as well.
So you've had the White Attire Fair at certain venues like Zanzibar, and what was the other venues that you've had it at before?
when the social marketing area really launched with the Human Endowment Fund,
mm-hmm.
it launched, really took off when our team was put together, the original board of the Human Endowment Fund was put together in 2002. The event was produced by Alvin King of King and I Productor, who launched a new era, and that was at the Warner Building.
Mm.
That was called the White Attire Fair, 2002 White Attire Fair, A Sunset Fantasy, and it was simply amazing. And I think to this day, everybody still remembers that event. It just was a great event. The following year after that was at the Reagan Building.
Right.
And that one's a mask in white.
Yes.
I think everybody remembers that.
I remember that.
Everybody really remembers that. That just a magical event. And that one drew about 1,300 folks. And then after that, oh yeah, then we had at the Mellon Building, Mellon Auditorium. That was off. That one was the carnival.
Mm-hmm.
And then that one actually became, up to that date, our largest draw, because we drew close to 2,000 people. It just like.
In that, in the Mellon Building?
Yes. It just blew up. It was it was the a carnival, a Yuma carnival, and that one was just simply amazing. And then we did the 2005, which was the Zanzibar you just mentioned earlier.
Yes.
And
I
that
remember.
One was Return to Elegance, which featured Alita Adams
mm-hmm.
and Shantae Moore. Everyone
mm-hmm.
loved that event. And then we took our journey back to the Reagan Building, where we had Models of Perfection.
Yes.
And actually, now that one became the largest in 2006. It surpassed the Mellon Building.
Wow.
So we had close to about 2,300 people. It was simply amazing. And I believe Herndon, he has the link.
Herndon Davis.
Herndon Davis,
okay.
Yes. And he has the little link, so you can kind of look at all the highlights and stuff on that. And then, of course, in 2007, we had the 007. Which featured Shirley Roth was sort of like the honorary chair of the event, and she performed. And so it's just been an amazing journey from the backyard to the creation of the Human Endowment Fund.
It's a little different.
To the creation of the Human Endowment Fund, and now we're coming like a full circle.
Okay.
Because with Alsura, it gives me an opportunity to kind of reconnect what the journey is. And I think a lot of people will be excited about just reconnecting the journey.
Speaking of reconnecting, are you going to use any of the venues that you once used before for Yuma?
I can't tell you that.
I mean, where is it going to be held?
I can't tell you. You got to keep the suspense up.
So,
I have some great ideas.
Okay, well, can you tell us?
I can tell you where I would what I would like to have. Since we're kind of going back a full circle,
mm-hmm.
I would like to, you know, have it like at the Warner.
Mm-hmm.
More intimate. I think people want a little bit more intimate. I
right.
don't necessarily think bigger is better.
Right.
I think people want functionality and service. And at the same time, that high level of what people can expect from the White Attire Fair. So if I had to pick where I want to have it, I'd like to have it at the Warner Building. There's some other spots that I would like to have it at. I can't name it off the top of my head.
Mm-hmm.
But, you know, Washington, D.C. has so many areas that, you know, you know, you could have nice events and everything. And we're working with a couple of production folks who already has it in the back of their mind.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, I know where I can have this event. So I'm very excited because we've reached out to a couple of production folks and they're like, yes, I'll do it.
Okay. Well, my next question, Nick, is I kind of touched on it before. When did the White Attire Fair happen and why? Why did you come up with it?
Well, the White Attire Fair started back in 1999, when my twin brother, 2 years prior to the first White Attire Fair, which was in 99, in 1997 he tested positive for HIV.
Oh.
And he's been HIV positive for 11 years.
Wow.
Yeah. When he told me, I was shocked. And you know, I didn't know what to do. I knew that there were folks in our community that were on the front lines of fighting HIV,
yes.
But there were no volunteers who were doing it from a grassroots level. So, you know, I just came up with a simple idea. You know, the theory of wearing white is nothing new. People have white parties all over the country. Nothing new. But I took the theme and said, well, I want to use this as a moniker to raise the awareness of HIV and AIDS.
Mm-hmm. Wow.
And then